And we're back here in this place with two additions, one being Danbury.
Yo.
And the other being this guy called Reno, who asks us if we are the Master of Fate. This is basically asking whose save slot to use. So when you say yes, it says, I want to use my save slot, and we will start off where I was. And then you can walk on through the portal and jump you and everybody
in the loading screen here.
Doesn't matter, I've already loaded it, so it goes really fast.
I'm still loading. God damn it, that's going to be really annoying when to do this.
Oh, I finished loading, so...
I'm done.
Anyway. So here we are, back at the Eye headquarters. We've got Commander Rimina to talk to again, but before we do that, I'm going to head on over to the armory and see if we can buy something new. The thing about the armory and really every upgrade, such as the medical upgrades, the psi upgrades, and the weapon upgrades, they all require certain statistics, such as a certain strength or accuracy level. And some of them can be pretty steep, so you won't be able to get the really good weapons even if you can afford them. We can drop by here. We can see that the BK-444, that's going to be the weapon that we kind of want to rush for. We clearly have more than enough Bruzifs, but when we try to buy it, we don't have enough accuracy. We're actually a little bit behind. The RN Kadori here is actually the most expensive weapon in the game. It'll be a long time until we get that. Really, the only things that we can afford, really, is the BK-222, which, as you can see, does a decent amount of damage, but it doesn't have armor-piercing rounds, and that's really what you want the most. And actually, my accuracy is just a little too low to buy the BK-222, so we can't get anything new. Lame. Something we can, or should be able to get anyway, is the stealth upgrade from the medic. So we can go run over and do that.
Don't mind me, I'm just chilling by where the mission start is, but I wanted to mention when I was running to the medic that this game has rudimentary waypoints where characters are supposed to be in multiplayer, but if a character gets too far away, it will stop tracking them. It does not start tracking them until you visibly see them again. It's quite annoying on some of the bigger levels.
Bigger levels? Kind of like every level in the game?
Figuratively speaking, I mean, you know, some are much bigger than others.
Yeah, kinda.
Okay, there, I can see. Alright.
Okay, so. Let's talk to Commander Rimna here. He basically just says that the mentor kind of screwed himself by showing that he's a traitor in the commander's eyes by looking at the cyber brain. And that the briefcase that we got out of the apartments in the last mission have some data in them that are, We don't really know the exact information. We got a location for some information that leads us to an old sewer controlled by the looters. I'm not really too sure why the information is in this place, and by the looters of all people who are a neutral party in all of this, but whatever. It's the game's logic, so... Get a little briefing here by this Geon. He just gave us a fake ID and a fake past. And so... Yeah, that's apparently all we need is a little fake driver's license here, and these guys will believe that the people in power armor are on their side.
Also notice that they instantly recognize us, even though, to my knowledge, we have no prior contact with them, no in or anything. All we have is the pass to show that we're part of the organization as a rookie.
Yeah, and not just anybody can see the boss. We have to go do stuff, like torture some survivors. Survivors from what? Mind your own business. And you know, I actually probably should have grabbed a weapon before I started. And I almost skipped over a quest. Wow, this is a great start. Anyway.
Hmm.
Wow, you got wrecked pretty quick.
I also might be lagging. Ah, yes. I got four, surrounded by four guys. Cool. Thanks, game.
Well, we just got a quest to find some drugs for this one guy. He'll pay us, so I don't see a problem in it. I don't know if I show this off in another part of the Let's Play, but this shotgun, the drum-fed shotgun, is one of the most broken weapons in the game. It has extremely good range, it's got 32 rounds and a drum, and really, it's just amazing.
It's quite a description. Oh, boy.
So now we're basically just doing odd jobs for the looters. Fortunately, since the looters are on our side, we have a little bit of help down here, but nothing really that great. We've got a lot of just random monsters to kill, and the enemy that looked like a girl, that's one of the more confusing and stupid enemies of the game. But we'll get to them in a little bit.
But you'll see it in larger numbers in a later part of the level. That might be a good time to explain. Yeah. Okay.
Now I have to check out something in a maintenance zone, but let's see what this guy has to say. He just needs somebody to listen to him. And he basically just tells us that he's addicted to drugs and he is disappointed in himself, that he has a family, and he has nothing to... He really has nothing to keep him on the right road, because he just keeps falling in with the wrong crowd. And he just does not see any way out of this vicious cycle. But I have a solution.
Jesus.
Problem solved. No longer addicted to drugs.
You really have a murder spree when it comes to people in this game. It's ridiculous.
Well, I am playing this game. I have to take out my frustrations on it somehow. It's not like there's any repercussions to killing everybody you see. I mean, look at my character. I have 11 karma. Well, okay.
Things have changed.
Yeah. In the very last mission, I was at 100. Well, I'm sure that'll change, because the karma amount really does seem to change at random. Sometimes you'll be at 100, and then sometimes you'll just tank.
Yeah, I've been at 100 for the longest time, and it has never changed. And sometimes I've been as low as 4-0, then shot immediately to 100 for no reason. Also, these guys are crowding up the hallway for no real reason, other than the fact they were probably drawn here by a monster, but all I know is it's blocking my path.
Yeah, and it was pretty nice of these guys to show the waypoint to the drugs that we were supposed to find. But I won't complain, I got bruises.
Yeah, you got Bruzos. It doesn't share a lot of the rewards with co-op characters unless you do it. Including hacked bank accounts, which is awesome. Especially because it doesn't tell me what bank accounts you hacked.
So this guy tells us about a legendary treasure that is apparently buried underneath where we are standing. It doesn't help us whatsoever. So... here's our mission objective, Gunther. He's going to be shutting down some doors that will keep monsters from getting in, but even if he shuts them, then the monsters will still be here. So we can sit here for 3 minutes and hold off the fort, and it'll take a while, or we could go the easy route and...
oh my god.
And it'll be faster this way, and there... none of the looters seem to care that I have killed 3 of their kind already. Probably one was a drug addict, so probably nobody liked him. Another one was crazy and thought that there was treasure buried beneath the sewers. And the other one, well, I'm sure there was a problem with him.
Well, they're not marked as friendly characters because they don't have the triangle above them, so I assume the game doesn't think you're going to kill them, as you saw, the dialogue continues whether or not the characters are alive.
Yeah, and that's not the last instance that we will be seeing of character of death not mattering to characters at all. But we'll see that in a bit. So now we don't have an objective. We just kind of have to wander around until the game realizes, oh hey, this guy is actually dead. We should probably have them do something. Really, the only thing to do right now is just take out some monsters and wait at the next objective location. Now, I just want to take this time to explain the stealth ability. The stealth ability uses up quite a bit of energy, and it does basically what you would think it would do. It makes people not see you up to a point. If you get right in somebody's face, then they're going to see you instantly, and you know they will gun you down very, very quickly. But we have our objective next. We don't have a briefing for it, we just see toxic barrels. What do we do with these toxic barrels? Well, we could wait for the briefing, or just toss it in the water. Yeah, so we are just given the objective to poison these guys' drinking supply with toxic waste barrels that they just happen to store right beside their drinking water. And I really am not sure why I wants to take out the looters so badly, because the looters are just a neutral party in all of this. I mean, it's not like they're the Federals or a part of the government or anything, and they really don't seem to care about the Federals at all. And for some reason, the Federals just decide to show up here. Not any ordinary Federals like we saw in the last mission. These are Special Forces Federals with cloaking devices. Now, I can buy that they put the Federals in the last mission that we were in because, you know, just street patrols and all that, but I don't know why they're just randomly sending Special Forces down into the sewers. Can you think of any real reasoning for that?
The game clearly didn't think of it. Why should I put in the effort?
And now we have to turn these generators on because I believe the reasoning for that is that the Federalists turned them off. So, yeah, I guess they're just letting the new guys do all their work, which will come back to bite them really soon.
I'm gonna grab this generator and then you can get the rest of the two, because
I already got the other two.
Alright, that works. The objectives sometimes aren't that clear, and sometimes the objective reticles disappear if you're far enough.
Or close enough.
Yeah.
In fact, just about everything will randomly disappear in this game. Whether it's a portion of your health bar, whether it's mission objectives, where your teammate is.
Ooh. Ouch.
Yeah, some of the weapons in this game, not only do they give you aim punch and the red screen, but they also knock you backwards. So they'll be shoving you around in different directions while it's shaking your screen and while it is turning your screen red. So it makes it really impossible to retaliate against a lot of these guys. I couldn't even hit him with a shotgun.
Well, I know games, especially this game, doesn't appear to be based on realism, but I mean, it is pretty hard to shoot back when you're being fired upon in real life.
In real life, you don't have power armor.
Well, okay, that white cloaked lady was apparently considered a master randomly because she was no different.
Yeah, this game will just randomly assign a quality to give to people, like a rank or a special setting for an achievement. Like, in one of the missions that we played earlier, I killed a Federalist, and apparently gave me an achievement for killing a really good dad. So apparently only one Federalist out of, you know, a couple thousand is a really good dad.
Unfortunately, no one is around to see it on my camera, but I just got killed by a friendly fire grenade that was thrown at enemies that were already dead.
Uh-oh.
Looks like they figured out something's wrong with the water. I wonder how you test it.
Don't worry. I'll check it. And, of course, the best way to test water is to just, you know, just get right in there. I like to get real close to my world. Real involved with it. So I'll just jump in here with the toxic waste.
Soak it up like rad yep. water.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yep. This water's fine. All we have to do is tell them the water's fine, and we will be full member.
Yep, the word of a completely new member that water is fine when he happened to be around it just 5 minutes ago is good enough.
Hey, he happened to be the one guy wearing the power armor from I. But we did get the approval of our double agent who was also wearing power armor from I. but don't worry about that because we are sincere. We are battle monks, but you know we are also monks. We aren't gonna poison your random neutral group of people. I mean, they're living in the sewers. What kind of threat could they possibly be to us? Why would we have to poison them all?
Clearly the biggest threat of all, if we have to poison them. You don't do that to any other major enemy faction.
Yeah. You...
Just these particular group of looters, fuck them.
Yep. We aren't even going to shoot them. We're just going to poison them and let them die from toxic waste in their drinking water. I like how they tell you to check the water because people are suddenly like dying and getting poisoned, and when you tell them that the water's fine, they don't really think, well, what else could it be then? They're just like, huh, well, that sucks for us.
I failed a hack.
My brain exploded, but don't worry, nobody. No one here seems to notice or care, so let me just try that again. Now, we have to hack the defense system because... I don't think... Like, we already got the data that we needed, so I'm not really sure why they have us hack the security system. I guess they just want us to kill these guys even more because poisoning them clearly wasn't enough.
If you ever notice me crouch randomly, you're not seeing it right now, but just in general, you regenerate stamina twice as fast crouching, which is a godsend when you're using so much. Oh, hey, you kill everybody.
Yep. It's much better to hack the system before you talk to the guys, because when you do talk to the leader... It tries to go Deus Ex on you by giving you some dialogue options that you might think would, you know, kind of change how you go through the story and, you know, develop your character some, but really, all three options for the dialogue literally end in, you kill them all. See, you can at least choose what their last words that they're ever going to hear are.
That's free choice right
yeah.
there. Oh boy.
You can make any choice that you want as long as everyone dies. Wait. Why am I bothering with that?
You know, I never hold notice there's a huge hole at the bottom of these stairs. Obviously, a very cheap way to die. You almost there? There
yep.
you go. Okay.
And that is the end of this level. All right. We'll see you back at the headquarters.